This is KCLA 3. We begin with breaking news.
And we continue to follow breaking news on the Caldor fire as it continues to spread east of the Tahoe Basin. Overnight, video from Echo Summit shows the fire burning down in Christmas Valley. You can see the flames and the smoke. The Caldor fire started in El Dorado County nearly 3 weeks ago, but crews are making progress on parts of the fire, allowing some people to actually return to their properties.
Here is the very latest information that we have from Cal Fire. The Caldor fire has burned nearly 208,000 acres. Containment is at 23%. Nearly 600 homes have been destroyed, and another 32,000 structures are threatened. Cal Fire is going to have new numbers on the Caldor fire coming up in just about an hour.
KCRT's Mike DeSell has been following the Caldor fire since it started.
And he's giving us the overlook at the flames from Echo Summit, joining us now live with what conditions are like this morning. What are you noticing?
And you know, Deirdre, a familiar scene now for people who've been watching us this week. We've been up here all week in the morning watching that spot right on the other side of Highway 89 above Christmas Valley on the other side of the roadway, that line of fire all the way up the ridgetop. And you know, it's interesting because fire officials, you know, been trying to explain to those who are concerned about this fire the difference between an inversion layer and a windy, clear day. An inversion layer means you're kind of putting the lid on a boiling pot and you're kind of robbing that of some oxygen so things start to lay down. As the smoke has come in this morning, you can see how these flames have started to lay down. Compare this to about an hour and a half ago. Take a look at this picture. This is, when we arrived here, we could see stars, the moon. It was clearer, not nearly as much smoke, much more fire activity on that line of fire as it creeps its way back down towards Highway 89. But this scene now much more subdued as more smoke has started to come into the valley. We also went on the other side of Echo Summit, the west side towards Sierra at Tahoe Ski Resort. Take a look at this video, and this is one of the few spots where we actually saw a small patch of fire burning a larger log, looking more like an oversized campfire, because all around it was darkness, which is significant because every single morning I've been driving up Highway 50 from Pollock Pines all the way to this spot, and it was not uncommon to see multiple spots of more significant fire activity. This morning, a lot less activity to be seen driving up Highway 50 towards Echo Summit and then over down towards South Lake Tahoe, and again back out here live above this kind of inversion layer. We can still see the moon this morning and clearer skies, but as we start to tilt down, my photographer Paul Westbrook starts to tilt down to this familiar spot. You can see how it's becoming much more hazy, smokier, and those flames much less intense. And again, it is worth pointing out that while these flames are right above Christmas Valley, keep in mind, we've been here monitoring this every day this week, and this fire just slowly moving its way down that hill. That is kind of what you want to see when you have active flames, because that just means that is much more manageable for fire crews than fire that starts at the bottom, gets some wind, and races uphill much more quickly. So as dramatic as this may look for some, it's still a good sign, and you know, helps to explain why the operations section chief has said that, you know, while we're not out of the woods yet, because we still have active fire that is on the move here, South Lake Tahoe does look to be in decent shape at this moment, thanks to all the work fire crews have been doing to build dozer lines above Pioneer Trail and Heavenly, and the way the fire has continued to burn on those ridge tops over to the east, above and beyond Heavenly Ski Resort. Live along Highway 50 here above Christmas Valley in El Dorado County, I'm Mike DeSell. Deirdre, Teo, back to you.
Yeah, boy, what a difference 48 hours makes, Mike. Boy, and what a great location for you to be live from all week. It's been such a cool way to see where the fire is. Appreciate it, Mike. Thank you. All right, President Biden has declared a federal emergency for the Caldor fire. A direct federal assistance will be given to El Dorado, Amador, Alpine, and Placer counties to help bring more aid to the fire. Now, some evacuees are being allowed to go home after 15 days under mandatory evacuation orders.
And people from Camino were told yesterday afternoon that the evacuation order was being downgraded to a warning. Last night, the Forrester Pub and Grill was a hot spot for people heading back into town. We talked to some people who'd been gone the entire time, staying with friends or family, and they say it was an inconvenience, but they understand why they had to be away.
And it was all for our safety and the safety of a lot of people's property. So there's reasons for all that, as bad as it might seem to some.
And a reminder from CAL FIRE for people who are going back into their homes, keep an eye out for current fire conditions. Although the orders where you live are downgraded to warnings, there's still a lot of communities nearby who are still under orders. And CAL FIRE says you should be keeping an eye out for emergency vehicles on the roads and for any roadblocks that might still be up. Here's a look now at the evacuation changes. So this applies to parts of North Camino and Pollock Pines, and it's only for areas that are north of Highway 50. Sly Park is not being repopulated at this time. Tens of thousands of people still under evacuation orders, and this map includes the orders in California. It does not include those across state line. And you can see the orders stretching south into Amador County and then into Alpine County near Kirkwood. Again, the orders are north of Highway 50, downgraded to the warnings north of 50. The full list of evacuation orders and evacuation shelters can be found at kcra.com. So with a hot spot of the Caldor fire burning south of the Heavenly Ski Resort, the firefighters are opening up a new fire camp that's very close by.
Our crews got video actually of the incident command center being set up last night in the resort's parking lot. This is the California Lodge. Officials chose this location because it has a lot of room and is very close to nearby flames. A parking will be a spot for fire crews to sleep, eat, refuel, and of course strategize.
We've got just over 4,000 firefighters, and we've got a lot of dozers and hard rolling stock that we need to make sure is taken care of and stored when not in use. So, you know, I would say we would probably looking at maybe half that number or maybe a third of that number on this.
We asked fire officials when people in South Lake Tahoe could return home. They say they don't have an exact timeline because fire is still actively burning in the area. They also said before repopulation can happen, they have to go into neighborhoods to survey gas lines, electric lines, and water pipes.